Hi everyone, this is Prabhjit Kaur, welcome to my channel. If you are wondering what exactly trade-off means, this video is going to give you the answer. Just stick around. Before directly jumping to the word time-space trade-off, I have divided this term into different chunks. So first thing, we have time, space and trade-off, and then we will club these terms together to understand the concept. So let's first understand time. Amount of time an algorithm or code takes to run fully or execute in order to give the final result. That is going to be the time for that specific algorithm. So this can be counted in terms of, mostly in terms of seconds, but we can also keep track of time in hours or in minutes as well. Let's now understand the second part of the term, which is space. Space is the total amount of memory storage an algorithm requires in order to execute and perform well so that it can come up and generate the desired output in a given time. So space or a memory storage can be measured in form of bits, bytes and so on up to the large units which you are familiar with. Algorithm will use RAM so that it can execute, and it will use secondary memory to save the input data. So space is going to be the total memory which an algorithm will take to store input as well as other things so that it can produce the desired result at the end and in a given time period. Now the actual term, which is trade-off. The trade-off is a situation where we have multiple measures under consideration, but if we try to increase one measure, then another must decrease and vice versa. Let's say we have two measures, A and B, and we are trying to increase A, then ultimately the B must decrease. This is the condition of trade-off. To better understand trade-off, let's take an analogy of seesaw swing, where if one person goes down, then another person must go up. Here you can compare one person with one measure which we have taken previously, that A and B. If A is going to go down, then B is going to automatically go up. So this is a trade-off between A and B. Let's now combine all of these terms. We understood what is time, space, and we also understood trade-off. Now let's combine these two things. In the previous slide, we have taken A and B. Let's say A is time and B is space. So we are going to understand time-space trade-off for an algorithm. So why the space-time trade-off is important for an algorithm? Because this helps in analysis and to find out the complexity of an algorithm. So why we need to do that at the first place? Because we want to pick the best algorithm. So what is going to be the best algorithm? We need to look at the average case possible, because inside the average case, particular algorithm under consideration will take less time and less space. The best algorithm is going to be one which is going to take less time and less space. But this thing is practically not possible. So we need to always compromise one over the other. So if we are trying to increase the time, the execution time for an algorithm, the space will decrease because the algorithm will take more time at the cost of space. So that's why it's important to consider time and space complexity, so that we can analyze the algorithm at hand. As we have seen six-step formula for solving a problem, into that one of the step was to come up with a list of different algorithms or different solutions. And out of that list, we need to pick the best one. That best solution is going to take less time and less space. That's why we are always interested in the average case I just explained to you. But this factors or measures are important depending upon where they are going to be used. Let's say in real-time situations where time is more important, so we are going to compromise with the space. So we will consider a less time, but we will use more space. But if space is a constraint, then we need to choose the algorithm which is going to take more time so that we can save the space. Nowadays, we have computers with large space. So space is no more a limitation. So we can go with algorithm which is going to take less time. The knowledge of time-space trade-off going to give you a benefit in understanding algorithm analysis and complexity, which we are going to discuss in the future videos in this data structure series. If you found some value in the content shared in the video, please hit the like button below. Also, do subscribe to the channel and don't forget to click the bell icon so that you don't miss any updates. Thank you for watching.